Selectmen Meeting to order April 10th, 2017. We have a busy agenda, so let's get right to it. If you're looking at the agenda, those first items are just things we really need to attend to tonight. They're not necessarily in order to attend to, just those are the important things tonight. Approval of minutes, we have both our regular minutes of April 2nd, where it was just Michael. Michael and I were in attendance, April 3rd. Thank you, you're correct, it was April 3rd. And then the April 8th workshop. So were there any, Michael, any comments or questions April 3rd and all of us on the workshop? Okay, by consensus, we're good to go with those. Community input. Sir, did you have something you'd like to talk to us about?
Yeah, I just want to leave off a building permit for Tom Clark.
Certainly, yes, we'd be happy to take it. He'll look at it, you know, probably next Monday, well, actually, he's coming tonight, so we'll give it to him. Still, yeah, thank you. Okay, I'm sure.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bruce.
Right, well, we're going to go to the Technical Review Committee, but the principals are not here. So, let's see where we can head to. Well, why don't we talk about, yeah, appointing, not reappointing, appointing members to the RPD Building Committee. I don't know why it says reappointing, but, okay, so, just so everybody knows, I think we had a really good session on Saturday in our workshop, and we made some progress in the sense that we've identified two or three really good options. And one of our next item, one of our next items of business is to appoint a, whatever we call it, a building committee or a location committee or something. And so, Michael, we were hoping that you could have something to put on the website to ask for folks. Oh, when did you do that?
6/18.
6/18.
Oh, today? Oh, that's fine, okay. Yeah, No, no worries, I'll,
Oh, I'm sorry, is that for the Technical Review Committee for the Planning Board? No, that's for the police.
Police, yeah, we're gonna solicit.
What are we, I just call it the Police Space Needs Committee, we call it whatever you want.
Yeah, no, that's, I, that's, works for me. So, we'll draft it, yeah. So I'll ask, tomorrow morning, I'll ask folks to post it. Shall we ask for people to get back to us by next Monday, so we can?
I put the 17th down, but I mean, I.
What is that?
That's next Monday.
Yeah, okay, sorry, that's good. And just so we know, we've already received one from Bill Irving, and Howard Hammond on the way out has offered his services as well, so. All right. So Chief, have you had, do you have any other thoughts or comments about the Saturday meeting, or?
I think it went very well. I mean, certainly it's a step forward, or we are moving forward. That's all we can ask at this point.
Do you have any business for us other than that?
Just a couple of purchase orders.
Why don't we do them, because I don't see Tom Clark here.
All right, purchase order number 1163 to the City of Dover. Cruiser 74, repairs to the driver's side seatbelt, and just to check the motors in the right rear, and I've estimated it no more than $300. And that'll come out of vehicle repairs line item number 707.
And I'll move purchase order number 1163 to the City of Dover for repairs to Cruiser 74, and the amount is $300.
Second.
Any discussion? I'll call the question, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
The Officer of Joy has requested a replacement for his duty boots, probably the ones that he has now, he's able to make it to the winter, but the bottoms are pretty much skids at this point. So purchase order number 1164, made out to Red Shoe Barn, the amount of $120 for a pair of duty boots. And that'll come out of uniform account number 257.
Move to accept purchase order 1164 to Red Shoe Barn for one pair of duty boots for $120.
Second. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
You don't have your credit card yet?
Not yet. The last purchase order is numbers 1165. I guess it'd be reimbursement to me for two Kodak digital cameras to replace the two bricks that we, really old ones that we have in two of the line cars. And $80.72 each, and that comes with a 32-gigabyte memory card. And that will come out of our equipment line item, number 280, and that was an anticipated expense for this year.
Also, the credit card.
He did.
Candy.
He's been waiting.
Purchase order 1165, reimbursement to Chief Ducharme for two Kodak digital cameras for $161.44.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
I just wanted to again thank the board for Saturday, you know, like I said, certainly step forward. So I really appreciate folks taking their time out of your very busy schedules to do that. I know we talked a little bit about the Silver Street property and the survey. And I just happened to be driving by Roberts Road today, and I saw Paul Conley out there and asked him, what would you cost the town, what would you charge the town to have to survey that piece of property? And you were familiar with it, you know, to some degree. But instead, you had mentioned another company.
Cardigan Mountain.
Cardigan Mountain?
Yes.
He's wonderful.
We find them, the garden clubs use them. They've been very useful. I know Nancy and Charlie have used them. You know, we sort of discovered him independently.
And where are they at?
Cardigan Mountain, somewhere, somewhere where Cardigan Mountain is.
He's involved in Lions, yeah.
Pardon?
He's out in Northern New Hampshire.
Yeah.
Right.
But he's been very, he's very professional. He's, seems reasonable.
Well, I'll reach out and just give them that.
Okay.
About 5 years, what they might.
Yeah. And I have an email. If you remind me, I can send you that email too, if you're interested. I'll otherwise forget unless you.
That's all I have for you folks. Anything for me?
Well, I would like you to hang around for the technical review committee conversation. And did John Krebs write back? I'm afraid I wasn't on the system after this morning. I'm hoping he would have.
I didn't think that wasn't on.
Printed, copied everybody. Oh, no, he's got a personal issue. He can't be here. Okay, he does have, so Tom is here, and Chief Ducharme is here. I don't see, and Jeff is here, so it's just Fire Chief.
He's here. He's out in the hall.
So let's see if we can bring him in.
Never mind, Tom.
Go, Chief. Hi.
Hi, thank you for coming.
You're welcome.
So we're here so that you can tell us what a technical review committee does, what, you know, and then we'll consider whether we would like to implement such a thing.
I sent that little memo to initiate the discussion, but primarily made up of individuals or administrative officials in the town that would have some input on a site plan or a subdivision. From a police perspective, it could be the 911 issues, addresses assigned, fire department, could be road width, road length, road naming, public works, could be, you know, how the road is constructed, so we need a cross section in the plans, as far as the thickness of the asphalt, et cetera. I could be there. Planning board representative, I think, is a good idea. Sometimes.
Planning board or the planning consultant?
Well, I think it's probably a good idea in that case to have both. And I think the planning board having a, well, because the experience that I've had, it was a planning board member because we had a planning director and he attended. So both guys attended. So I'm thinking that.
The employee as well as the board.
It probably would be a good idea, I think. It's not to create a committee that gets out of hand or so many people that it's unwieldy, but just everyone there to offer their area of expertise so that when the plan goes, because one of the issues that John brought up was timing, and I think that the TRC, the applicant should meet the TRC before
it even gets on the planning board agenda for exactly the reasons you stated. I mean, there could be some revisions.
Yeah, I'm gonna read what the, I pull it up right now. This is John Krebs, we hired to be our planning consultant this year, as he has been for the last few years. I think the board is probably just going to be a lot more involved with working with him. So these were his comments on a technical review committee. He said the process is optional.
Yes.
So that's, you would agree with that?
And part of my response was, to be clear, it's the board, either the select board's option or the planning board's option, not the applicant's option.
So, all right, so what's the idea?
Okay, so that, yes, so what, somebody comes in for a major subdivision.
Yes.
You know, a five-lot subdivision. It goes to the TRC first. I mean, the applicant doesn't have a choice. It goes, if this process is established.
Yes.
The applicant doesn't have a choice. It goes to the TRC. It pretty much meets on demand because we're not sure when it would be necessary. So the applicant and the engineer sit down with the TRC, and we look at the plan, pretty much judge it for compliance with applicable regs from the town, you know, whether it be subdivision, site review, zoning, whatever. And in that way, I think it streamlines the process, because by the time it gets to the planning board, a lot of that stuff has been resolved.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'm not really sure the activity level of the Wallingford planning board. It's been, you know, a couple of times, but it might just streamline the process. You know, in one case, I can think of a minor subdivision that went a couple of times, and there was still some confusion, and, you know, I mean, that kind of stuff, I think, could be clarified before it even gets to the plan.
Something like a minor subdivision where there's just a slight adjustment in the lot line wouldn't need to go, I wouldn't think, right?
It wouldn't, no.
Okay.
So who makes the determination then of whether it goes before the technical review committee or not?
I think the criteria need to be established by the planning board and or select board. Like Mike just mentioned, I mean, if it's just a lot line adjustment and there's not any, you know, creation of any non-conformity, of course, then it's not a big deal.
If I may,
yes, absolutely.
Probably the best way to proceed would be to have Tom, John, and us create the criteria and then present it back to the full board and to the planning board.
You, Tom, and John, is that what you do?
Sure.
Is that okay?
I would like to set on one.
Oh, perfect. Okay. So these two board members, Jody and Mike, mm-hmm. and you and John Krebs, one of your first tasks will be to sort of, I mean, assuming that we're going through with this, is to create the rationale. So when John says that the TRC process is optional, what did he mean by that, do you think?
I'm not exactly clear. I think he wants to leave it, that's why I tried to clarify that it's not the applicant's option. The applicant can't say, I don't want to go.
I see.
It's if the option being, I think, the criteria that we establish or will establish to say that is, I mean, I guess you could say it's optional, but if we establish a criteria and the person meets that criteria, then I go.
And then his other comment was, there's no mention of the town's planning consultant as a member. Well, that was, that's because I just part of it.
It was also, you know, I thought of it, but I wasn't quite sure what his title was.
He is our planning consultant.
But planning consultant, so
yeah.
Certainly.
I think he was referring to the fact that I sort of left him out of that email, but I was just, it was just understood in my mind that he would, do this, he would be a part of it, yes.
Double out, what happens if these people go to this review committee, go through the review committee, go to the planning board? The planning board chooses to say no. What are the repercussions back at us?
I don't.
Because
they've
jumped through every hoop we've asked them to.
Right, but we're not the final approving authority. The committee is not the final approving authority. That clearly lies with the planning board. So
and if they need every RSA, and the planning board still says no, then what happens?
The person can appeal the decision to the Superior Court, but I don't think there's any obligation on our part to say, or the board, the planning board's part to say, yes, you went to TRC, therefore This is, you know, it's a blank approval.
That's what I, like, are we creating another level to get rid of the planning board?
Oh, no, that's not, yeah.
Like, well, I went to who you said so, and then the planning board says no, and they said, well, you just wasted my time to come.
The idea is to have a complete application. There are so many times, almost every time.
Right.
Not every time, probably 9/10 of the time. Applicants come in with incomplete applications, I mean, that need additional information, either by error or omission sometimes. And this would help alleviate those problems. So an application that really should take one meeting sometimes takes three, four, five. I mean, it takes a lot more time of people that are volunteering on the planning board and the applicants that are paying, you know, their consultants to come in and represent them, so.
So my understanding was that it was an administrative help, just to make sure that the package was put together, that there isn't an oversight, you haven't addressed, you know, you haven't addressed this.
Yeah, I think that was one of the things that John, number four, that it's advisory only, which.
Right, that, yes.
That's exactly what we're looking for.
So if an applicant has questions about our zoning ordinances, and they need, you know, technical assistance.
Sure.
Filling out the application, it's appropriate to get that information from the advisory committee, not an individual member of the planning board, which is what happened in the past.
Positively, yes. I think that kind of addresses what John's number five point is.
Yeah.
That he's not sure that a planning board member should be part of the committee, but I personally disagree. I think it works very well. We've had it done, you know, when I was working for the city of Dover, it was done that way, and it was never questioned or challenged. I think where his probably concern comes in is if a planning board member, you know, looks at an application, as you point out, and says, well, we need to do X, Y, and Z, or a planning board member goes on the sidewalk and confers with an abutter, and the abutter gives him, you know, some information. I think at a TRC, it's not an opportunity for a board member to, you know, establish their opinion.
Right.
It's just to get the information and make sure it's a complete application.
And to be fair to the past chairs of the planning board, and they did that on their own because there wasn't this mechanism in place, so.
Right.
Not like they were trying to do anything nefarious, so.
Right.
So this came through late in this day, and I'm just reading it now.
Did you send it to all of us?
I just forwarded it on. I thought he had not.
Okay.
So, and so John Krebs's comment about a planning board member, he's not sure about that because it could result in the member being disqualified to sit in the application if they have made any prejudgment.
See,
good point.
Yeah, that is a good point.
I do like that point.
What do you see as the advantage?
Well, I think if the planning board member sits at a TRC and says, I don't like this plan, what difference is it if it goes to the planning board first and he sees or she sees the plan and says, I don't like it? Because, I mean, it's just not a personal issue. I think what he's worried about is a potential conflict where, you know, there might be some advantage or disadvantage of the applicant getting approval from somebody. But to be, I think, on a committee, as a member of a committee, to say, this is what I think you should do or this is what I think you shouldn't do, I think it just provides some valuable insight for the applicant. And certainly that one person is not the whole board.
I understand, but I don't know how I feel about having a planning board member on it.
The RSA mentions that the planning board can name town administrators. It doesn't say the town administrative officials. It doesn't say specifically to include or exclude planning board. I just, from my experience, we've had it and it's worked well, but if you choose to establish it without.
Well, the other thing that occurs to me is that, you know, we're a small town and a public official sometimes can be stretched really thin.
Sure.
So if we could manage this, if we could start this out, and you know, the board may still have some questions, but if we could start this out as an administrative review with administrators, you know, that might be a good way to start. So
let me add if we needed to.
Yeah. So Jody and Mike, what are your thoughts on this on a technical review committee? Is it worth it to have them come back to us with?
I like the idea, but what does it put in our budget for Tom's extra time and John's extra time?
Bingo.
So, is it built into their budget already?
I
Well, it's gonna be as needed, so we have no idea.
We have no idea. So right now, we don't have a problem. We've not used John to full capacity over these last 2 years. We've built a budget that has 10 hours a month for him. So, you know, not that he has to use 10 hours per month. And so we'll, you know.
How far are we stretching you, Tom?
Oh, I don't think at all. I can still work it into my regular, you know.
Okay.
I don't think that's gonna be an issue. I really don't.
They are gonna be a lengthy meeting, I mean.
Right, there shouldn't be, and if we want.
As a major.
I mean, they could come in, you know, sometime during the Monday before the meeting into town hall. So if we want, we can just schedule it, you know, for a certain time on Mondays.
When they're working.
They're gonna be on demand before go to the planning board, so they pretty much would be our choice.
Yeah, so Mike, if you look back over like the last 12 months or something, how many projects that have come before the planning board might have been suitable candidates for a technical review committee?
I think over the last 12 years, all of them.
12 months?
All of them, probably.
Well, I.
Almost all of them.
Yeah.
How many?
I don't know how many.
I could think of five.
Okay.
Since I've been here.
Okay. In 1 year?
1 year, 2 years.
Five across, I mean, that doesn't seem.
We didn't have a huge number this year, but I think all of them probably could. There were, just for instance, the Clement Road project would have, in my opinion, benefited greatly from the technical review committee, review first. They came back several times for issues, some of which, you know, couldn't be resolved by the committee, because questions still that some of us still don't really have real answers to, that's okay. We're in the minority, so. But it would have benefited. That's probably the biggest one from the past year.
Now, what about the use of our road agent, our chief of police, and our fire chief?
Yes, I mean, that, the Clement Road project, for sure. I mean, the cul-de-sac at the end, it went back and forth several times.
For plowing issues.
For plowing and everything else, and fire, safety. We never problems with police's time on that one, but, well, actually, there could have been with the line of sight actually coming in and out, really there was, so.
So would our three public safety folks be willing to serve on such a committee, assuming that we went forward with this?
Well, I've always welcomed, in the last couple of years, under Pat Macklin, he has forwarded plans to us. I know the fire department, you know, specifically, like the Gadman issue, and then the Chinburg project here, the most recent two anyway. So I know we had an opportunity to look at them and make recommendations and whatnot back to the designer. So this
provides the opportunity for you all to be together and listening to one another's thoughts and concerns, right?
There could be conflicting concerns.
Yes, absolutely.
And yeah, in the past, we've done it separately. This was a great idea, have us all sit down together, look at the plan together to make sure that we aren't conflicting.
Correct. And we have had conflicting opinions on road width for public safety issues versus expediency. So
and versus pervious and impervious road
correct.
Service.
Most definitely, yes. Yes.
It's hard to.
Yep. No, that's right.
It's hard to serve all masters.
Yes.
So are we thinking that we want to form a technical review committee and as their first task to come back to us and give us sort of guidelines of how it would operate? Is that good? And I hear that we have two board members who want to serve on that. And so do we need to notice that, or can it just, yes, we need to notice that?
We've always posted it in, you know, okay, it's a public meeting. It's not open to the public, it's a public hearing.
Perfect. Okay, so Caroline and Tom, if you want to just kind of coordinate that and bring these folks together, chiefs, road agent, two board members, and John.
And John.
Yep, sure. Super, thank you.
Cool.
All right. Thank you for coming.
Anything else?
Oh, there's, yes, yeah, some.
Oh,
We had a building permit, somebody dropped by, we also had this, why don't you, I'm. Well, this is our salvage thing. So.
That's not yours.
Oh.
Not that I know.
Yeah, I think that's the only one I have.
So here's compliance.
Just right in the committee.
Oh, no, I was just looking what they had done for.
So we should probably talk about this tonight, but we'll put it in your folder, it looks like it's something with DES for.
I'm just seeing if we've made it.
Oh, yes.
Contract.
Yes.
You've seen it?
Sign off.
Okay, so we'll note it tonight and then we'll pass it on to you.
Great, thank you. Welcome.
Yes, what else?
Do you want to talk to Tom about the Clement Road culvert and any role?
Oh, okay. Yes, do you mind staying another couple of minutes?
Not at all.
You almost got away, Tom.
So we got a really wonderful email. It didn't detract from the fact that it's serious in purpose, but it was nice to not just be yelled at. So from the Randalls on Clement Road, who, they live near this substandard, non-standard, whatever, culvert under a road. Underneath, it's a pipe, there you go. Hard to even call it a culvert. And so Jody responded and was going to try to meet with them, and they said.
They were out of town, but I was more than willing to walk the ground.
And so I guess Jeff, did you go visit? Why didn't you tell us what?
Yeah, actually, the day I received the email, I went down that road and the ditch line of that road where the water was going into that culvert was dry. There wasn't a ditch of water that could come.
Was there water on their property though?
I didn't see any.
Okay. So.
Well, that's why I wanted to walk the ground, because the picture that they showed me looked like it was way in the backyard that way. The road's over here. And their septic is here. So, and if we do have to do anything, that culvert isn't a legal culvert, so we have to drain it down the side of the road.
Yes.
Because we don't have easement across the street on the other people's properties. So, you know, we can drain it towards that drain pipe on that side of the road, but I didn't see any water. So, and it looks like they have a berm on their land before the road.
They have some very low spots on their property which are containing the water. So either, you know, on an older house or whatever, maybe their perimeter drain isn't working properly anymore. So the rainwater that's coming off of their roof is saturating the ground, which is causing water to enter their basement. You know, the ditch line, I haven't taken a measurement yet because I don't go on people's property without their permission. But that culvert is, in the ditch line, is a significant distance from their property.
We do have, not that this solves the problem today, but when we worked on the road plan, Jeff, we did take note of that. We were on a road that will try to come up with a drainage plan for that side of the road.
Would you mind going out and seeing what I thought I saw?
No.
Because it looks like the septic is in the back and then a low-lying backyard, but then a berm before the road.
Would you like to go with Tom? I mean, is that helpful?
Jeff,
okay. So, and then you can help draft a response and you would be able to.
Sure. The water from the pictures I saw are nowhere near.
The road.
The road, the culvert.
So
it's not the fact
to do a walk,
plugged up.
Because I'm like, wait a minute, this does not look like what I expected to see.
Right.
Yeah. From these pictures, it doesn't look like it's an issue, a town issue either.
Right. So.
They're concerned. I mean, you know, I need to know your concern. So we will try to develop a response.
Yep.
And so if the two of you want to look out, you can draft something. Jody will have some ability to respond.
Yep. Sure.
So.
I could, like, either you draft something or I draft something, it's fine. But from the pictures, I wanted to do a physical walk. I'm like, this is not what I expected to see.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I was expecting to see water built up right by the road. It is.
Were you here when this first came up?
Yes.
Okay. I wasn't sure when you talked about it.
But I had never seen pictures of it, so. And I had never been on the property.
Is this allegation accurate that the Someone plugged the culvert?
We have.
Yes.
Oh.
It is true that it's an allegation. That's all I can say. It's true that it's an allegation.
Well, it was plugged, we don't know.
That's right. It was plugged, or it's whatever.
But it's not on a culvert of any of our maps. It's.
Well, it's in our.
It's only a 12-inch pipe, right? And it didn't show up.
What they did is, it looks like a piece of ductile iron, 12-inch ductile iron, and someone just put it across the road.
Do you know when? Can you even hazard a guess?
And isn't it, it's not a lead pipe, is it? Is it?
No, steel, ductile iron.
Oh.
Drill casing.
Yeah, but it's only like.
12 inches.
Yeah, so it's not a culvert.
Well, 6-inch, actually. It's actually 6-inch.
But nonetheless, it's in our right-of-way, so we own it. And that said, so they're, what they're telling us, the Randalls, is that, well, look, this is your culvert, and it's in your right-of-way, and keep it clean and moving, and blah, blah, blah. So I'm just saying that's the issue.
Right, and to do it right, we would have to drain it down the same side of the road, because we don't have easement across the street.
Well, and that's why, you know, when we've got the Clement Road notes, we've got that as a note for that, when we do Clement. I just, off the top of my head, I don't know when that's coming up.
10 years.
I don't know. Did you look?
Oh, it's like 8 years. It's before my road, I know that.
I'm 10 years before my road.
Me and your last.
All right, all right.
Oh, my God, I don't mind.
All right.
I'll look over that, and we'll take it from there.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tom, appreciate it.
Thanks.
All right, let's go back to the agenda.
Thanks.
Ron, do you have stuff for us?
I do. It's actually a purchase order in the blue folder. I wasn't sure I was gonna make it tonight.
Okay.
It's for the hydraulic pump for the skid steer sweeper. It's a cool company. We've been using it for the sum of $450. Did you put it in?
It's the only one in there. The only PO in there.
I'm getting it.
At the bottom, I think.
Hydraulic hose assembly, one sweeper. Didn't you buy this?
Nope.
We held off.
We held off.
Oh, that's right.
I ended up being introduced to another dealer. This guy that supplies deals in hydraulic pumps and motors and cylinders. A couple of other people in town use for their businesses. And so we went from $1,100 to $450.
So move to accept purchase order 1172 to hydraulic hose assemblies for one sweeper pump for the skid steer sweeper for $450.
Any discussion?
Sounds a lot better than $1,100.
Sure does. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Cleaning the highway department, we did get that email. I'd like to table it for this, unless there's a burning. There was a request from Jeff that we hire Richard Fogarty to clean the bathroom at the highway department. I don't know, didn't it come to all of us? Why did?
It did. Did all of you? It was probably a week ago.
So, but I would like to table it so we could just run some numbers, and maybe we could run some numbers, but.
There are numbers in there, but they.
We've got other things to. Other big things, so I'd like to get on to that. The Rollsburg Grade School fencing, we did bumped it up the chain, and they said, what? So.
Well, I just want to make sure, because there was comments made.
No, absolutely, and they assured us that if they were going to do something like this, that they would in fact contact the select board.
Okay.
And we would then bring the appropriate folks in. So there is no fencing going on at the grade school.
Perfect.
Okay.
Yep.
And.
It's another one of these dreams.
Transition from the backhoe and hauling snow still.
Do we not get a correct invoice from Mick?
No.
Okay.
It's not corrected. I've brought that to their attention, and they've not provided a corrected invoice, so I need to follow up with them again.
Okay. Do we want to talk about the recycling equipment proposals, or hold off for another week?
Table.
Table, okay. So, but I would like to have just a, maybe a few minutes public discussion on the fact that we, if we do accept this proposal, it would be sort of like lines of a, it's not really, can't really call it a sole source vendor, but, no. You want to tell us what you know about Atlantic Recycling and other transfer stations?
Yes, all of Lamprey Regional uses Atlantic Recycling for the containers, the compactors, the equipment that they do. Everybody in Lee and Madberry and whoever has one, that's all they use. And Madberry just can't speak highly enough of them. And our shipping cost is going to be much less than anywhere else. Considering they have 5 feet to go.
Yes, around the corner.
Yeah.
And Jeff, would you like to say, you know, your words of encouragement about Atlantic Recycling?
Yeah. You know, there is only a couple of vendors around that, that deal in this, this specialized equipment. You know, I'd like to use Atlantic. The simple fact is they do a lot of favors for the town, as in if there's an issue on a Saturday, they'll come down free of charge. They've done, they do all our PMs every year for free. And, you know, and if we need a piece of steel here and there, they kind of just give it to us as a, you know, here, there you go. So, you know, they do money for the town free of cost. And I'm afraid if we go with somebody else, then we're going to have to up our budget significantly to.
Mark, do you have any concerns about that? Just as, Jeff, we're not going to look at the quote tonight only because we have a lot of other things to do and it's good until, so we'll probably try to address it next week.
I remember what piece of equipment was, but 4 years ago, we were purchasing something, I can't remember what it was, but we did put it out to bid, and Atlantic was the least expensive, if I recall correctly. And they're also local, which is also nice, so, I mean, I don't know of any conflict, but I don't.
Yeah, and just for so everybody knows, I mean, we're not, I'm not relating anybody to Atlantic Recycling. Yeah, I don't know anybody else. So we, so there's no conflict of interest, you know. So we would try to get the best value for the town, and we may choose to just go with the one quote from Atlantic. But we will.
I only know them from Lamprey Regional Co-op and from the NRRA.
Yeah. Okay. So, but I think the quote did say it was good till May, so. So we'll probably table it until next week when we, and we can address a bunch of the transfer station project.
Absolutely.
Okay, good. Is there anything else, Jeff? Or do we have, Jeff?
You have a list in front of you.
I do have the list.
Your Volvo back?
Oh, the Volvo.
Table it?
No, I've met with all the vendors and they're, I'm waiting on them now. I've met with Case, John Deere, and Cal to see, you know, I'm waiting on them at this point in time.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Jeff.
Anything else?
I don't think so.
All right.
Have a good night, Jeff.
Hey, thank you.
Mark, would you like to come and chat with us about the fire engine, and we'll we'll see where we are with things.
Okay. I have one piece of business first.
Okay.
One purchase order for, you know, kind of ties right in with the technical review committee that we've been talking about. This is tonight. This is for 3-year membership dues to the NFPA. And the NFPA constantly gives us all their annual updates, whether it be, you know, road widths or, you know, turning races and all that stuff. So, we just stay up to date with all the latest publications and whatnot. So like I said, 3-year membership, NFPA, this is number 1135, and it's for $445.
Okay. Purchase order number 1135 for the NFPA for a 3-year membership use for $445.
Seconded.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Good to get on with the really big thing. Okay.
Yeah, the really big thing.
All right, the really big thing. So So, you know, Mark and I had a conversation last night, said, well, you know, are we gonna be able to do this today? I says, Mark, I can't say that, right? I'm not the board, so, you know, you have to, it has to be in front of us. But here's what I suggested, that we review with Chief Rutherford tonight any other issues that we might have about the contract, anything along those lines. And one big thing is about to be cleared up today, and that is we got word from our council this afternoon, who has a resolution from our bond council that will allow us to appoint our treasurer as our treasurer.
Yeah, so your fiscal agent is now in place, so that gets over her.
Right, and it will be Jody and I, you know, I mean, Michael can agree to it as well, but Jody and I have to be the two who have to do this, just, you know.
I'm like, why?
Yeah.
Never mind.
So I wondered, board, if, so we could use this time now to talk to Chief Rutherford about any remaining questions we might have about the contract. And if we thought we would be ready to rock and roll, we could invite Chief Rutherford and the rep, I don't remember his name, to come a little bit before the 6:30 meeting on the public session on Wednesday. So we would notice it as a short meeting in order to...
sign all the proper...
Yes. 6:30, it's a public information session. It's not a public hearing, it's just our assessors.
Yeah, the reassessment thing, sure.
We're meeting at 6 for that.
I thought I had too many to schedule at the same time.
Pardon?
We're meeting at 6.
Who's meeting at 6?
On Wednesday.
I thought it was 6:30.
Six it is.
The public information session?
Mm-hmm.
Who did that?
I don't know, but I have to be all day, hoping to make it back.
Well, who did that? Well, no, clearly. So, would a little bit earlier work?
That's fine.
So you have a, you can't,
not a problem.
I'd like us to you know, to fully understand and review and ask any remaining questions. So the sort of Wednesday would be kind of a pro forma. And while I value you highly, as you know, the two signatures that really need to be on that thing are, you know, just until we can get over this hurdle. So can you
drive slow, Mike? You don't need to speed from Keene in an hour.
So can you be here? Is it more than just, I mean, assuming that the board is going to resolve any remaining questions, ideas, whatever that they have, do you envision
Jerry,
needing to talk to us about anything in particular?
It's all going to come from your side of the table, whether or not.
How many things are there to sign? Is it? Is just the one? It's the contract.
Yeah, it's the form right here. I've given you one before, and it's.
And if you change this change order thing to the select board.
That's it.
Right, but it refers to.
Refers to the rest of them.
Yes.
As far as the actual signing. And what it's going to require everybody to do, that is all there is. As far as the change order thing, he's aware of that, and that'll be changed to the Rollinsford Select Board. And,
okay.
We went over that the last time.
Yeah.
So if we sign on Wednesday, with that 270-day window is still valid?
By 2 days.
By 2 days. All right, perfect.
At 5:30, would that give us enough time?
It should give us plenty of time if we're just signing.
Yeah, because basically, Jerry is he's a full-time firefighter in Rochester.
Okay.
And, you know, to be truthful, probably if we had set up something for tonight, it probably wouldn't work anyway. I'm lucky I'm sitting here because we were down in Portsmouth at 1 o'clock in the morning.
Wow, really?
Till around almost 11 today. And there's an engine company in Dover with the fire that Dover has right
mm-hmm.
now.
Yeah.
So we've been to Dover twice. We covered Dover with Portsmouth. Now we're back over Dover again. Not a long day. Mm-hmm. And Jerry was the same way because he was on Rochester's piece of equipment that spent the night down there. So, probably would have been tough to do it. So, in that big picture, that big scheme, the Wednesday is going to probably work well, provided nobody has another general on fire in the area, whatever the plan. It'll work out fine. If we want to do 5:30, because I didn't, like we said last night in our conversation, I didn't want to commit to anything, because he had to find coverage for his shift tonight. He's available anytime we need him on Wednesday. So, if we want to do 5:30 or 6 or 6:30, that's just a matter of me
Well, we're doing the information session at six, I'm told. And so, I don't know, that's going to last as long as, you know, residents have questions.
Yep.
And so I can't put an end to it. And so I think it would be better if we would meet before.
Yeah.
So, I mean, is the board have any lingering questions or remaining questions now that we've gotten the, you know, the treasurer's position out of the way?
No, the big hurdle was the bond company, so.
Yeah, okay. And financing will either come from the USDA loan, the municipal bond bank, or commercial credit. And I have, all three of them are in good shape for being passed. We have, you know, so I don't think we are at financial risk. The DARA grant is going to governing council by April soon, And so, which is, you know, as it turns out, thank goodness, because now, once that is fully in place, that will change what we need to ask for from either USDA or the bond bank or.
Yeah, once you have that in place, you can, you know, drop the number down and know what you're at.
Exactly, so that will be a good.
And as it said in the contract here, and it was an issue for a while, was, you know, they don't want any funding or any payment until the thing backs into the station. So it's not like you're making payments or front loading it or anything.
Yeah, no, that's really good for cash flow. That, you know, that worked out well when I was kind of outlining cash flow.
Yeah, I had that discussion with Caroline, the same kind of thing. So it pushes it out far enough, even 270 days, we're looking at December.
Right, and you're good with that, that acceptance window is sufficient for your needs and you'll be okay with that?
I just want to see it signed being built. It's kind of my, that's just been my goal, is to move forward with the whole process. And I think, you know, between all the conversations and the work that you people have been doing to try to get all this stuff ironed out, we finally made it.
All right, so we won't actually make the authorizing vote until right before. And we'll notice, can you put that out, Caroline?
Yes.
So what time do we want to make it? 5:30? Would that be okay?
That'd be okay.
Okay, so we'll do 5:30.
Yeah, I'll get in contact with you, Jerry, and say you're available at any time, and we'll plan on meeting in Dillon at 5:30.
Okay, very good.
Excellent. That's all that I have. Do you have anything for me?
How long will you enforce my selection?
We started that way around 1:00, and we got kicked out of there after 10:00. We were at the fire in the State Street.
1:00 this morning?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
It started.
So they lost the whole State Street Slim building to the second building.
Is that what the fire lost?
Yeah.
The State Street Slim building.
Oh, my goodness.
Three stories. There's a smaller building next to it.
Yeah.
And there's a four-story brick.
Yeah.
Next to that, the four-story brick has got it too. They're just deciding whether or not they want to take it down.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's that stone church on the fire end.
Yeah.
So basically everything from where State Street is to that stone church.
Do they know what started?
They're trying to say it's in the kitchen. But the owner of the building kind of disputes that, because from where they think it started, he says there was nothing in there that has anything to do with their cooking or food prep or anything.
Wow.
So they're never going to know.
Yeah.
There's nothing left.
That's a huge loss.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
They're never going to be able to go and investigate and find out anything, because just three stories fell into the basement, so you don't have much chance of finding any real reason. They'll have to just go through the interview process and maybe something, some direction that they can make a.
I heard that one of the businesses had just renovated, didn't they? Like days earlier.
Yeah, we'll do some lot of renovating now. But it worked out well, because on the other side of the street is that big white 3.5-story building. It has Louis Restaurant. There's a, you know, a hairdressing place and 20-something apartments above that. So once it started spreading that way, too, they weren't so much worried about the brick and stone church. They worried about that alleyway to that next to
right.
And that's where all the work was concentrated right there. And that, man, we decided the building's all cooked, but you replace the side, and you know.
And everybody got out okay.
Everybody out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a question for a while. They weren't sure that all the residents had made out. That was confirmed this afternoon that it was accounted for. So, said and done.
Thank you all.
Yeah.
And we'll see you Wednesday at 5:30.
Wednesday at 5:30. Very
right.
Good.
Thank you. All right. Caroline, I think you're on. Thank you. It's welfare, right, so we'll need to turn off.
I move that we go into non-public session for the purpose of the welfare discussion.
Second.
Roll call, Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne? Yes.
Yeah.
this is basically an unfinished folder that comes directly from the front office. That's their line of communication.
Okay. Are you involved then?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the select board, in case number 2015-24, is recommending $421 in rental assistance.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
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 Thank you.
Have a good day. Nice evening. Okay, I think we're done with,
And that case is 2015-24?
Correct.
Okay?
Yes.
All right, town administration. So appointments, planning board consultant is there just because we, you know, we're trying to get a little contract together with him, but he is our planning board consultant, it's John Davis. Treasurer position. So let me set the stage for what we're going to do next. Let me reiterate what I said in an impassioned way last week, and that is that this board, this entire board, town moderator, our town council, the municipal association, et cetera, all believe that we had a fair and valid election on Thursday, March 16th. However, the legislature has thrown a bit of a pall over that and may require us to have a special town meeting to ratify, you know, one article that ratifies mm-hmm. the vote mm-hmm. in March. The problem is that the timing is, doesn't work for our working with bond council to get clearance to do long-term financing. And so in ongoing conversations with our town council, with the bond council, we are, as long as, you know, Jody and I sign all of the related things, we're fine on the board's point of view, but the treasurer, you know, she has given us a resolution to read so that we can appoint our treasurer as a temporary treasurer until this gets resolved by this second town meeting. So,
so the legislature actually has scrapped that plan.
Oh, what are they on to now?
The Senate on last Thursday adopted an amendment to one of their election laws to give the governing body of towns, us, authority to hold a public hearing, whereas residents can come and express their pleasure or displeasure that would move the election, and then at the end of that public process, we can then ratify.
The board can ratify the election.
But it's only passed the Senate. So.
Okay, so again, it's up in the air, and so what we're going to do is read the resolution that was provided to us by bond council, and at least Jody and I will act upon it. So would you like to read the resolution?
I will.
Okay.
Declaration of vacancy and motion to appoint temporary town treasurer pertinent to RSA 41:55, pertinent to RSA 41:55, in light of the uncertainty created by the rescheduling of the 2017 March town meeting, excuse me, due to weather emergency, the town of Rollinsford Select Board hereby finds the town treasurer to be temporarily incapacitated and declares a temporary vacancy, and hereby appoints Beverly Dion as acting town treasurer, excuse me, to perform the duties of the town treasurer upon such time as the 2017 March town meeting election results are finally legalized, ratified, and confirmed.
So will you make this resolution as a motion?
In the motion?
Did you move that? Okay, I missed that. Okay, then I will second that.
Thank you.
And say that all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And actually, I'm going to do a roll call just so that we're absolutely mm-hmm. Clear. Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
And Suzanne? Yes. So, I'm going to read that email to make sure that there's nothing else that we need to do. I did notify Beverly of this. I'll call it an insult, but nonetheless. And this is from Kevin Bowen. Let me just make sure that we are good to go with everything here. I've attached a copy of the declaration of motion to use at tonight's meeting, which we just did, to appoint Beverly as temporary trustee. please send me a copy of the duly posted notice and minutes for this meeting to me and Renell as soon as they are available. All right, so duly posted notice, I mean, this is like a standing meeting, so I'm not sure exactly what that means, but, okay.
And you will send that to me?
We will send you a copy, yes. We can note that.
We'll include them in the minutes.
Yep, absolutely, we'll include it, we'll include the resolution. Please send a copy of the duly posted notice and minutes for this meeting.
Just in general.
In general, yes. And this meeting is, you know, it's a stand, as a matter of fact, we put out a notice when we're not gonna meet. So, you know, I don't think that that's gonna be an issue. So as soon as we get the minutes from you, we'll pass them on, and I will make sure that you get a copy of this. And that appears to be the last issue with bond council, I think. Okay. Budget, I don't think there's anything to say about the budget, I am working on the first quarter report, and I will operate this group before the budget committee. Cash flow, so as you know, I've been working on cash flow issues, and a couple of things. So I'd like to request of the trust, I'd like for the board to request of the trustees transfer of the money for the bond warrant articles. Yeah, we just, I thought it was going on, I had something on letterhead. Okay, we'll just do it this way. So this lists all of the articles where transfers are going to happen one way or the other, except for the bond ones. And so I have just toted it up, town hall drainage, 55,000, town hall security, 10,000, public safety, 50,000, because 25 is coming from a grant, not from the reserve funds. Command vehicle, 40,000, and the town rebound, 70,500. I didn't put the service truck, there's a little uncertainty. So that adds up to $225,000. So I would entertain a motion to request that of the trustees, and I think we can ask Caroline to help fix it. Yeah, however you would like to move.
All right. So I will move that the select board request of the trustees of the trust fund that they make the transfers that are applicable to the 2017 transfers that would be authorized by the town meeting.
To the amount of, did you say?
The amount of $225,500.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, I will sign the request. Okay. And with regard to cash flow, I pushed out, we didn't have any discussion, but I did push out to the board a plan that I put together that would help us manage the cash flow. Did you have any questions about that? It's, you know, there's a lot of coming and going hither and from, you know. I won't try. Oh, toing and froing. Toing and froing. There we go. Okay, so then the other thing that I would ask of you is that I made a preliminary, had a preliminary conversation with Kennebunk Savings Bank on short-term, you know, sort of bridge things. So I will continue to work with him and bring back information that I find. Is the board good with that? Okay, excellent. Compensation values for easements, Wednesday. What is that saying on Wednesday? It's possible, it is possible that Caroline wanted us to meet with Chad to get an idea ahead of time. He will be here Wednesday. So I think when we talk, when he's here for the meeting on Wednesday, maybe he will have for us suggested compensation values for easements. He's not surveying, but he went to take a look at, or will be taking a look at the properties, and he knows where the rights of way are and that sort of thing.
Okay.
So Wednesday we should be able to get that
great
from him, we hope, because it'd be nice to see that ahead of time. Okay, and then as far as our the projects themselves go, other again with regard to the easements, we are meeting with property owners on Friday at 11 o'clock to, well, Tanner will be here. They will explain the project, they will explain the nature of the easements, and that these are permanent, and that we will, town will be making offers to them. Not that they have to, I mean, they can of their own goodwill provide it to the town at their cost, but we do have it in our budget. And I don't know, what was the response? I know that we did get a response from the Municipal Association on public comment.
Email says it has to be a public process.
They don't, the quote-unquote negotiations aren't privy to neither one of you, so.
Those kinds of negotiations?
There's a bar they have to meet now with the attorneys. Give us a second. From Margaret, the two or three meetings, as we know this, which is more than one, yeah. Consideration of the acquisition, sale, or lease of real or personal property which, if discussed in public, would likely benefit the party or parties whose interests are adverse to those of the general community. Based on the limited facts I have, it doesn't sound to me like the danger of benefiting another person with those interests is present in this situation. Margaret Burns. Staff attorney. But it has to be noticed if more obviously, if more than one officer.
Right.
So, the public process.
Okay, here's my concern. My concern is the property owner and what the property owner might, feel, but we'll just let it go.
We follow the advice.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Are you gonna be here just for 11 o'clock, or are you gonna be here for the pre-meeting at 9:30 as well?
Well, if you have to post it and make it public, because the school isn't here, it would be easier not to.
Well, if I were a property, you know, I'm just thinking about, you know, we haven't done this before, but.
Right.
But, you know, do you want to be talking about that with somebody else who?
Exactly.
Yeah, so.
So if I were the, I'm looking at it from the property owner's point of view. I would like some privacy on negotiations.
Yeah.
But here's the problem, you're using public dollars to do the negotiations, and that's why I think the Municipal Association.
But it's not their choice.
But we don't have to do it if it's not a public, if there's just not.
Wait, did I not hear that right then? Sorry, Mike.
Let me do it again here, I'll see.
The actual easement will come back to the whole board to
right.
review and sign. This is just to get it to.
So if there's more than one of you, yes.
So if there's more than one of us, so.
But if there's not more than one of us.
Then we can do it such that it's not a publicly noticed meeting.
Mm-hmm.
And then the request will come back to the abatement.
So ultimately it'll all be a public anyways, because it'll be discussed in public meeting. But
yes,
we'll
there's
come only
back.
One of you, I mean.
So, what are we thinking?
Originally, time. So the question was.
Transparency.
The question was, we were having the Friday morning to discuss with five property owners the need for the town to put a permanent easement on their property for the purpose of culvert maintenance. The meeting was going to be managed by just one board member, but now another wants to attend. Must that meeting be public? There is an anticipated potential to have to negotiate with the property owners regarding compensation for the easement. Is that sufficient grounds to notice that it's not public? I appreciate your thoughts. And it says, yes, if two or three select board members will be present for this meeting, I believe it must be held in public, at a public meeting. For it to be done as a non-public, it sounds like the only option in that area where to.
Right, but it's only if it, otherwise it's not a board meeting, it's just one of us, and we can't act, one of us can't act.
Correct.
And so we would just be doing the preliminaries.
Correct.
With
we could do that.
The board, with the property owners, bring it back to the board. It would be public. We would say what the
like you want X, they want Y.
Yeah.
And you can't make any decisions to bring it X plus anyway.
Correct. Right. Whoever's there can't grant the, you know, we could bring it to a certain point.
Right.
And I also don't want to put somebody who might be willing to do it at no cost to the town, to all of a sudden have a process that, for whatever reason.
So, yeah, I'm more than happy to stay at home. Or if you want to stay at home, I'll help.
No, I've been involved, so I'm happy to continue with that. And we'll bring the information. We'll bring the information back to the board. Excellent, thank you. So, let's see. Town Hall Drainage, all right, notice of award. So somewhere there is a notice of award. So we left the Town Hall Drainage with our acceptance of gaining construction as the low bid. And this is just the next step in the process. It notifies Gangen that they have been officially awarded this bid, and it gives them a certain number of days to return to us with the various bonds and insurance things that they need to give to us. And we've also asked our legal counsel to draft a contract that we can use once we get the stuff back. So, do I have a motion to provide this notice of award to Norman Gangen Construction for $38,228 to do the exterior drainage work?
So moved.
Thank you. Do I have a second?
Yes.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. I will sign this notice of award. And there will still be a contract left to sign. This is the next step.
$38,228.
$38,228. Okay. Letter regarding trees at Chin. Can I step back here a minute? I think, okay, let me go back to the legal. I don't think the board discussed this. I think that I asked legal counsel if they could do this for it, but not to do anything until they checked with the board. The board didn't talk about this. Is this correct?
We did. You wanted me to draft one, and then I saw an email saying that Tom Lark was going to draft.
No, no, this is the contract for the drainage work.
Oh, I'm sorry, the drainage. I thought we moved on the trees.
No, I just backpedaled because I saw the question mark saying, you know.
Okay, sorry.
You know, so many things happen, yeah, that's okay. So what I did in order to prepare for tonight is I asked Steve if he could do it, that we were just administratively overwhelmed at the moment. Could he write the contract for us for the drainage work? To Gangen, but not to do anything until I check with the board. So here I am checking with the board.
So
this notice of award is not the contract.
Right.
So we had the specs,
right.
Okay, the notice of award, and then the contract kind of refers back to the specs.
Right.
But it's, you know, we need a legal contract in order.
Right.
Rather than asking us, Caroline, whatever, to try to write a contract, I asked Steve if his firm would do this, but don't do anything until I check with the board. He would write the contract.
Steve Roberts or Steve Height?
Steve Roberts.
Okay, I thought Steve Height or Hayden Howard was going to be.
He doesn't write
okay.
The contracts.
All right. All right. He may not write.
Okay, there's a puzzle on this side as well. We're talking about the exterior drainage. So
right.
We did a public bidding.
We hired Steve Bite. We have the engineering.
Yes.
We have the contract. They know what they need to do.
We don't have a contract. We have the specs.
Yeah. So you just want them to draft a contract?
Just a contract.
Okay, so
that's what we do.
$1,000. Mm-hmm. Is it in the budget?
Yes.
Yeah.
And it would come out of the warrant article.
Okay. Because to have, what's your other option?
To have no legal protections. Or undefined, I mean, we've had contracts for Bear Road, both Bear Road.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we've got one tonight for the next round of work contract.
Yep.
So it refers back to, refers to the RFP for scope of services. It talks about how, you know, if there are any, if there's any contention, this is how the contention is managed.
Okay, yeah, I see what you're saying.
Well, take a look at what we have for Bear Road. We didn't ask him to do that because we've been doing our road contracts, so it's really just an adaptation of the one that we've been doing. But this one is different.
Yeah.
So.
No, I understand, okay.
Okay, you good?
Yeah.
So.
I'm just.
We'll see the contract, this just.
No, I'm just worried about the budget more than anything.
We have budget dollars to cover.
Okay.
So, we don't need a motion, I'll just say yes, can provide that to us from, in our legal work, and then it'll come back to us and we'll then read the contract. Hopefully sign the contract. You sure, you know, we can talk some more about it, you know, if you wanna walk it through again, there's some more work done.
Because, yeah. So they have, yeah.
By consensus, we're going to ask. It's actually going to be Kevin, I think, because he was maybe out of the country, but, okay, can we do that? And while we're on it, with regard to Kevin and legal, property in Jesse Doe Road, it's possible, I thought we had followed 4-4, whatever the RSA is. Well, we met twice, but the Conservation Commission has no, and I hear back from the Planning Board.
We went to them.
For Fogarty.
Or I went to them, rather.
For Jesse Doe?
One of us did, yeah.
You can't find, do you know, can you find dates?
Wasn't it a split vote until they had no recommendation?
No, that was Silver Street.
That was earlier. Yeah, that was the Silver Street. Or something.
Yeah, just based on the funding.
Yeah.
It wasn't even relative to what they were actually supposed to be ruling on, to be honest with you.
Yeah, it was when we were trying to buy the property next to Silver Street, next to the Highway Department. That was the, Fogarty, really, there's been no, not Fogarty, sorry, Jesse Doe. Really, there's been no hue and cry over Jesse Doe. I thought we'd fall, because I can find, we have two meetings, appropriately spaced.
And the Planning Board gave a recommendation, right?
I didn't hear back, I asked, can you tell me? And I didn't hear back. I don't know if I have a wrong email, or what. So if you can find out from the Planning Board, and if you went to the Conservation Commission, if you look on your calendar, I know I went to the Fogarty one, and I went to the Highway. Geez, we started, well, April of last year is when the board had its two public hearings. And then the vote was later in April, like 20-something. So it would have been probably before then.
When does the Conservation Commission usually meet, you know, when that's?
Thursdays? Awesome. All right, so you can sort of check on that. All right, so now we are on to letter regarding trees at Chinburg. And so do you know?
I was going to write them, okay. And I saw an email that Tom Clark was going to handle it, working with Caroline. Well, Caroline's writing it after Tom Clark goes up and looks at it.
He was going to look at the plans, actually, as well.
I didn't write the email that I saw, so I didn't write it to him.
All right, so we'll just wait till we see a letter from.
I wasn't going to write it if someone else already was.
Absolutely. I don't think there's any activity on the New Hope housing tax exemption. We've already dealt with the transfers from the trust funds. Rec committee, I'll talk about financial management. If there's anything else that you want to talk about, we can do it too. So I did meet with the rec committee last week. She reviewed the hire, they reviewed the hiring and firing. So everything this year is coming here. You know, just first year, so everything will come here. It's possible next year we may say, well, if you hire a director, maybe, you know, maybe the director can hire the, you know, the, not the assistant. I think that might always come here, but I mean, it, what is it, the counselors? And then for financial management, you know, Caroline reviewed, we reviewed petty cash issues, reviewed the transportation. And everything seems to have lined up. I'm not going to be able to remember any of the detail. I think Dee was going to write it up, but we're going to record revenue in three or four different lines so that you'll be able to, not you directly, but any of us will be able to say what came from registration, what came from sales and services.
Lester's doing an internal tracking of that. Anything that comes in from shirts comes directly to him. I'm CC'd on that. Anything comes in from registration, he's sending it to him. The director will do sales of snacks and stuff during the summer, and donations of whatever we get will come in as well. Carolyn, as far as the pool goes, the pool needs a head count. You have to pay them that day. But Kelly talked to the pool, and they said, well, we can do a head count. We'll give you an invoice on Friday night, and then we have to get it to Caroline first thing Monday morning. So I'm thinking, I'll pick up the kids on Friday night, grab the invoice, and just drop it off at Caroline's desk, so she has it first thing Monday morning.
Yeah, that's pretty much.
And then she can cut the check, and then we'll have a purchase order on Monday night for that check, and then they can give it to them on the following Friday.
And they
that
were
right?
Yep. And there were other the bus bills us, so that's an invoice we'll get from the bus. We're gonna seed them with petty cash of $50 for incidentals, going out to get food or something. And mention if it, you know, if it starts to grow towards 100, it just, you know, come we'll make a deposit. Or if it gets low, you know, we'll buy And I think that was Caroline. We did talk about credit card payments, and so if there's an opportunity, you know, Caroline could do something over the phone. It would depend on the amount. She, you know, if it's more than 200, she'd have to come to us if it were, you know, to get some advance approval. But so we just talked about credit cards. I don't know that there's anything right now that it would be used for, but we just mentioned that that was a possibility. Caroline would, you know, we would be giving them a credit card. Caroline would be managing.
She just calls.
So, anything else that you wanted to bring up about?
We determined guidelines for sponsoring children. And we're going to use the federal poverty guidelines, 200%, which is a bit. Like a family of four is $49,200. A family of seven is $75,280, and so on and so on. And they'll provide either last year's tax returns or four current pay stubs, which is kind of like how mine works.
Are they just going to show them and then walk out with them, or are we keeping them?
I don't recommend keeping them. It's going through me. No one else will know who is a sponsored child and who isn't, because their first thought was, well, we'll ask Kate who's on reduced lunch, and Kate can't give that information. So
I think, yeah, Caroline might have suggested that. And I can see now that yes, what you're saying is correct.
So where we're supervisors of welfare anyway, I think it should go through me. I'm the only one that knows who has that and who qualified for that.
The reason I was asking is because I don't think we should hang on to those things. So
I don't want that.
I'm happy to hear you say that we're not, you know, you're just
going
to look at
I'm just going to initial it. Yes, I saw it.
Okay, perfect. Okay.
So.
All right. Mike, do you have any
questions?
Okay. Policies, procedures, welfare. So I took out some of the other things that have been there because we're just not finding time to work on it, but I put welfare there because we haven't brought that one to completion. And you mentioned welfare a few weeks back, so I thought, you know, if you had the opportunity to work with Caroline, on that and brought the policy to us, that then we could.
You mean like presenting it to you?
Pardon?
You mean like?
Well, I don't know what's.
Presenting it to you?
There's a draft somewhere, but it has to be gone through. So, and it never gets gone through, so we never see it. So I'm just looking for somebody who can bring this to us.
Okay.
So we can look at it.
There were one at Rochester, Dover, some as well.
Understood, but whether we have to make edits or maybe there are some.
I thought Sherry, you did. I thought that's what she was working with.
Supposed to go to legal counsel.
Yeah, I haven't seen a welfare policy. Have you?
I haven't seen a policy, I've just seen the paperwork.
Yeah, so I think, so.
But I thought that was state paperwork.
I don't know, I don't know. We, the town has not adopted a welfare policy.
So you want a welfare policy?
Yes.
You don't want me to take over welfare?
Oh, no, I didn't say that.
Okay.
This is the first step.
Okay.
This would be the first step. So let's get the policy in place.
Okay.
Right, so that we know what it is that you're taking over, we've got it written and that sort of thing. So.
You love policy.
Well,
Caroline did the same thing this morning at joint law, so I'm just laughing about policy.
Yes, yes, and we do have in our budget to have a legal review of the policy, once it comes to us and we see it and we're fine with it. So, that's why that's there.
You sure you want a policy? Sorry, you want a policy of something we've been doing all along?
Yes, we've been doing it without a policy, which is not a good thing.
We've been following the same policy guidelines at Rochester, Dover, Summersworth I've been using, we just haven't ratified them because it needs.
Okay.
So where it says Rochester, where Rollinsford needs to be substituted.
Fine.
Almost, basically. We wouldn't want to go over them again, we want a legal counsel to go over them to make sure that everything would work for our community.
Okay.
So it's not that we're recreating.
We're not recreating a policy, we just.
Yeah.
What we're using needs to be ratified by us, and that step has not been taken, that's the next step. So if it's just a question of changing Dover or Rochester or Rollinsford, but there may be some other things in there too that just don't quite fit.
Yeah, that's fine, that's fine.
City manager.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Are we good on that?
Yeah.
Okay. Super duper. Now did we get, because I'm down to the town, to standing items, so let me go back to the top, make sure we've done everything here. We did the treasurer position. We're set up to meet with Chief Rutherford and Jerry, I'm sorry, I don't remember his last name.
McKay.
Thank you, Jerry McKay, at 5:30 on Wednesday, right? We will notice that as a meeting. And if Chad is here, we may include that as part of the meeting too, the talk about abatements. You know, so it would be official, kind of like an official report to us, if that works out. All right, so we did that. We did the notice of award to Gagnon Construction. Oh, contract on the road, well, we did trustees of the trust fund. So contract on the road, is that?
I did not see any paperwork on that. I saw an email.
Yeah, we had emails, is there no contract?
Oh, great.
There's something here that's a non-public contract.
Yeah, that is different, that's different, yeah.
Yes.
All right, thank you. So for the last 2 years, the board has created a request for bid process for our road work. It's been Bear Road Part 1 and Bear Road Part 2. In both cases, we had five bids, five responses in one. We had three responses for the second. And in both of those cases, Pike Construction was the lowest bid. Last year, I was maybe amended by saying he's the lowest qualified bid. There were only a few thousand dollars difference. This year, the board has talked to Chris Matheson, who's the rep salesperson, the rep from Pike, and asked him if he would give us a quote for our road work this year as a proprietary quote.
Mm-hmm.
and that we would then either give an up or down vote to, but we would not release any figures unless we were willing to do it because it's private. So, so I think the, and again, as it with Atlantic Recycling, I think it's important for us to note that neither the road agent nor any of the board members have any relationship with Pike Construction.
Yeah.
So we have a quote here for the road work, and is the board willing to move to accept this, this is a contract from Pike Construction? I won't say any money until we've got anything for, okay, we're okay with this.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm gonna ask one of you to move this contract.
All right, I move that the town enter into a contract agreement with Pike Industries for road paving for grant and associated drainage work for, and shoulder work for a grand total of $292,293.
And this is for Foundry and Pinch Hill.
Pinch Hill.
Yes. Second?
Second, I'm sorry.
It's okay. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And what was the amount?
The amount, $292,293. This is coming from the road warrant and the operating budget.
Mm-hmm.
Fire is the town of Rollinsford. Yes, which isn't much. Chris, well, a couple of things. Of course, Chris said that he does these conservatively, and it's true that last year we didn't spend the entire quote.
Yes.
That's one, although he's also saying that the cost
going
is
up,
going
so
up.
So you want to get it done now rather than later.
Yes, which is why he was. He said
right.
That to us and said you might want to.
So, but I just want to keep it on the radar that we only have 7,000 left
for patching.
Line.
Yep.
So.
Unless this comes in less, or unless we move things around.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Great.
All right. Ooh, thank you. All right. So, so I think that was all the stuff that we had to sign and talk about.
I thought they had money for patching.
So.
No, Madam Chair. You're...
Pardon?
No, no, Madam Chair.
Well, can we do, can we,
yeah.
So let's just
yes,
let's finish up here, if that's okay. So standing items, board member activities and updates. So Wednesday, we're meeting at 5:30 officially as a board to sign the contract for the new fire engine and perhaps to talk to Chad about what he thinks are abatement values, not abatement, easement values, sorry. And Friday, I will be meeting with Hoyle Tanner at 9:30 as a refresher on all that we're about to do. And then at 11 o'clock, we'll be meeting with the easement, prospective easement folks. We had a little bit of a thing with the school district because a permanent easement can only be given to us. The school district can only give the town permanent easement at a school district meeting. So Hoyle Tanner said, for purposes of what we're doing, the temporary construction easement suffices. So that's not an issue, but it's a little ironic. And I'm meeting with Stormwater tomorrow night, it's been noticed.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else happening?
We just had our rec meeting. We'll have it again on the 23rd
mm-hmm.
At 7, and then again on the May 9th, which is a Tuesday night at 7.
Oh, you said Sunday?
So, yes, it's First Communion. So, I was not going to be here, and I don't
there
think
you
even know if you wanted to go.
Are things going well? I mean, they seem like they're going well.
Oh, they're so
they're
organized.
So, yeah. Organized.
They did roles and responsibility the other day, last night, and they love spreadsheets as much as she do. So.
Excel is the best application. Michael?
Okay, yeah, so the planning board met last week. Miles England is the new chair, John Hinsman is the vice chair. Mr. Hinsman was here, we should talk about the other meeting that happened that week.
Oh, I'm sorry, that was him, he was the one who came in.
So, the select board, the planning board also, I didn't make it on the agenda for some reason this evening, so we'll have to take it up next week, but they would like us to accept the fee schedule that they've set.
The planning board?
Correct. The only two changes are, for registered mail, that goes out to abutters, they want to raise up $10 to cover costs and the staff time, and $250 for notice to the paper for the meeting.
Yeah, that is more expensive.
Because it's a lot more.
Do we need a public hearing to change fees, do you know?
Yeah, planning board held one back in November, December, I don't remember. You can, I guess, if you want to, I don't think you have to. But there it did, the select board just has to ratify them and then they're going to be.
A recommendation, so it would be a recommendation from the planning board who did hold a public hearing on this.
And then it goes into the site review.
Okay.
And subdivision.
Okay. Right, and are they going to do subdivision regs at some point? Stormwater subdivision regs?
Yes.
Perfect.
Have to speak with the new chairman. But also, the historical committee met, I got tied up at work, I didn't make it to town in time for the end of their meeting, but they want to sell magnets to begin raising money for the work on the pump house, you know, the slab and all that, that they hope to do. They have a line in our budget that we approved, the town meeting approved $300, and I don't think it was less than $100 they had to spend, so. And they want to sell them that old home day and whatever, a family fun day, and there's a scoop something, or the ice cream scooping thing next week, I think, or something like that.
Yeah, the schools have the ice cream.
Two weeks from now, I think, 2 weeks.
Oh, I see, the school is holding it and you'll sell magnets, I see.
Correct. So, there's opportunities to sell, and if they're successful, they'll do a different image on it, obviously.
So.
It's going to be the town, new town.
So, and what happens with the revenue?
That's my next question, so.
What happens with the cash?
What we need to figure out is, right here, need to either figure out how or where to deposit. Because they don't have a, a line in a sense, you know, they don't have a count, so we can figure that out too.
Right, so here's my suggestions, I kind of mentioned it to the rec committee too with regard to the scholarships, if you get more scholarships than you need. So Caroline can create a revenue line.
Okay.
I mean, we need to deposit because there's no other mechanism for us to, So
that
it has to be,
understand.
Yeah, it has to be a town deposit, but we can do it to their, to a line that says historical committee revenue.
Something not like that.
Well, right, but here's the thing, we're not talking about a line.
No, we're not.
Right? So what we can do is take a look at that amount that has been collected this year and next year add that to the budget.
Okay.
You know, so it's kind of a patch work way of for now until we come up, and I did the same thing. I said the same thing to them about the
It's not going to be a substantial amount.
You know, the sponsors. You know, if they get more money and you have children to sponsor, it's still only going to be 2017 revenue, but we can add that to your budget next year. You know, for that purpose, until we can figure out how to manage it in a kind of a non-lapsing sort of way.
Yeah, just an active revolving fund, but that needs to be.
It needs whatever it needs, and I don't know. So we can manage that just internally with the budget, our own budgeting process, I think.
So the other thing that happened the same evening, the historical committee was meeting, was the ZBA met. And I hope Mr. Hinsman would have stayed, because we appointed Mr. Hinsman to serve as a member of the ZBA. Apparently, the chairman of the ZBA would not allow him to participate in the case that was happening that evening and put one of the alternates in instead. He claimed he wasn't a member, he wasn't appointed. When two of the members of the ZBA said, well, yes, he is, Joe, we all got an email about it. Joe said, no, I never got an email, even though he responded to all of us, email saying that we were appointing Mr. Hinsman, so I'm not sure. We may need to reach out to the chairman of the ZBA and let him know that Mr. Hinsman is in fact a member and should be, is a full voting member.
So I can send him an email and say, Joe, would you like to talk to us about, you know, we believe that we've appointed John Hinsman, and if you have questions or concerns, come see us. I mean, you know, we'll just do it that way.
Sure, but you certainly need to reach out to him because.
Yeah.
He was appointed.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Well, thank you. Anything else?
Enough.
We're busy. Oh, yeah, there is one more thing. I am continuing my conversations with USDA, and so I'm meeting with Ann Getchell, who's in the USDA room this Thursday. Okay, we'll do community input, and then we have to go into non-public again for purposes of contract.
Take care of the folders.
Oh, I'm sorry, yes, of course. Sedation.
Like I said, it's about.
So I don't have building permits, but apparently I have things from the front office that they all come in here from what I was told. So first is just an advisory copy for the select board. It's a notice to, from the Board of Tax and Land Appeals. It's a notice that goes out to all tax collectors. They have to fill in when tax bills go up for, I just read it to you. Please complete and return this form to the Board of Tax and Land Appeals no later than May 1st, which already happened. In accordance with the provisions of RSA 76:13, the tax collector shall notify the Board of Tax and Land Appeals in writing, bolded and underlined, of the date on which the final tax bill, bolded and underlined it, was sent. A tax bill that establishes the total tax liability. Complete the information below indicating the date of mailing of the final tax bill covering taxes which were committed to you on the official, original rather, property warrant for 2016 municipality Rollinsford when they were filed on November 9th, 2016. And notes that we have semi-annual tax bills signed by tax collector, but we're supposed to be aware of that.
Do you want to see? Okay. Thank you.
Sure. It's a mouthful, but we should all be aware. Okay, so the first purchase order I have is 1185. And it's made out to Interware Development.
Oh, yes.
It's the licensing of the software for the dog licenses. It's $350.
Which is in the budget. That was a motion.
Oh, second. Is this an upgrade every year?
It's not an upgrade. It's a maintenance license.
Okay.
It's, you know, software support. So,
oh,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So we'll get it every year. So that way, if something happens, she calls, they fix it. You know, we get upgrades. If the software is upgraded, we just need to get the upgrade whenever it happens.
Part of the deal.
Yeah, it's part of the deal. All right. Any other comments on that? All right, I'll call the question. All those in favor, say aye.
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 And the other purchase order is 1186, made up to LHS Associates for the town election for the ballots and software, minus the school portion. It is $1,259.42.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So we can go back to them?
Yeah, this should be filed, I guess, with us. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. I'll just keep all this stuff together now.
The other thing, before you get started, Jody, when the tax collector thing went by, it reminded me that I spent some time, I think it was last week, sometime recently, uploading all the stuff to the DRA that we need to upload, like the minutes of the town meeting, the thing we sign, et cetera, et cetera. So we are up to date with all of the things that are supposed to be on the DRA's website as of the end of March. I mean, there's a bunch of that, so we're all done.
Thank you.
So, okay, onward. I'll let you manage the discussion on that. It's from Caroline.
Okay. So, So Caroline is asking to go to a class Friday, April 21st, legislative update. New Hampshire Government Affairs staff will provide mid-session update on legislative affecting municipalities, including state budget, right to know law bills, utility valuation, and postpone town meeting votes. It's $15. So, am I reading that right?
Probably.
Probably.
Okay, I don't have a problem.
Michael? Okay, so by consensus, we'll say, okay. It doesn't rise to the level of PO.
You done with these?
Okay.
And what is that class?
It's a legislative update by the Municipal Association.
Okay.
Mid-session update.
Mid-session update. What's the cost?
Yeah, $15. Bad lunch.
That's probably the $15.
I was just gonna say that, probably the $15.
Enjoy your sandwich. So this is the purchase order to Chad and Bay Ross for the electrical issue they fixed on the backhoe, and we had to wait till after town meeting.
Mm-hmm, okay.
So, and moving further with this, we will need to submit this now.
Yeah, we should pay it, you know, if we want to object to it or whatever, we'll have to take some other means, but the recommendation Caroline had was to pay that invoice, and then if we objected to it, to take it to legal or something.
Right.
Well, in the meantime, we have other things we're asking them to do, and so if we don't pay our bills, we
can put a line of credit.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's the issue.
Yeah.
So it depends on what we want to do, but.
Alright, so move to accept purchase order 932 to Chadwick Bay Ross for $585.48 to fix electrical issues with the backhoe slash transmission.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And then we'll look at this sign.
There's gotta be somebody else that'll fix that.
Pardon?
Work on the backhoe, there's gotta be somebody else that'll fix it.
I don't know, it's time to look. Could you pass that to Sally? Yeah, that's not for the roads. We can, that's part of a non-public road.
Right, that's what I thought. Double checking on everything else in here has been going through. Yep. All right, so you have a letter to sign. Select Board has been appraised of the following activity on your property on Front Street of renovations.
So is it needing to be reminded about a building permit?
Yeah, just this Front Street, but the owner of the property lives in Dover.
Okay. You know, it just says French, she didn't put it on this, but I'm gonna sign this.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, they come on multiple years, but I don't know if they own all the things. They own that whole block, maybe.
Yeah, probably, and so I don't know what's being done.
Yeah, they're doing too many.
Yeah, I don't know.
Your tax pay rate increases last week.
Oh, yes, there was,
But this one changed.
Yeah, something changed. I thought she was going to highlight changes. I don't see highlights. Oh, right here, yes. She said she started out with the wrong starting salary. So she fixed it.
So it's the same one here. This is the starting. This is the starting. What did it change? Did somebody's change and not the whole line?
Detail work changed.
Right? That's the same.
Well, the answer's different. Oh, why is the answer different? She had the...
This can't be right.
That's right, so I don't, maybe, so this is right.
Okay.
Yeah, so I don't know, it wasn't the starting one, it must have been some other error.
It was the finishing one.
Yeah.
Well, either way.
Well, one is regular, one is overtime, yeah.
Okay, so she didn't separate it out for this one.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Yep.
Do you need to see it? And I will sign? Okay. Okay, and Chief Ducharme's also okayed it.
Yes. Comcast agenda for renewal process, keep them folder, do you want to table that for now?
Yeah, I mean, we've asked Steve to manage that, so.
Okay.
I don't have any updates.
Okay.
We have a public hearing though, right?
We have a public hearing.
On the 17th. Some Wednesday, so.
No, Monday.
Monday is.
Next Monday.
Oh, okay, next Monday, okay.
At 6:00.
And I'm just reminded, I got an email from Tom LaBelle, he's wondering if the school can, I think he's looking to see if the school can get some bennies from it. We're not sure that anybody's gonna get any bennies, but I'll forward it along.
I think that's why, yeah.
I'll forward it along to Steve.
Who are trying to get information out of Mr. Gillis, right?
Yeah.
Is that City of Dover?
Yes.
That's it for the folder.
Okay.
And other things out here, so this is from New Hampshire DES and the auto salvage yard on 160 Summersworth Road. They were investigated by DHS and they have 45 days to comply with evidence. They need evidence of the correction action to include photos, receipts, invoices, and other pertinent paperwork. And they have multiple violations, so, with pictures, so. And it goes on for.
This is, I'm sorry, which is this Summersworth Road or is this Clement Road?
Summersworth Road.
It's Summersworth Road.
Days Auto Salvage.
The actual one that's licensed.
Yes.
So what is our, should we pass this along to Tom for further review to see what our next move is?
Yes, and he needs to know about.
Okay. Can you, would you like to put?
Didn't he do the walkthrough this year?
He did.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and this, and he's the one who got this to happen.
Okay.
So, but let's put a, can you propose it, just say, what should our next step be, Tom, or something like that? Absolutely. Let me put the post in there.
Yeah.
All right. Maybe you can just, what is our next step?
All right, and I'm hoping one of you can help me on this one. The Zoning Boards of Adjustment public notice for the Land Use Department of Barrington Town Hall. Owner is a revocable trust on 304 Young Road, Barrington. Applicant is Varsity Wireless Investors out of Boston.
What is our interest in this, do you think?
They're noticing us of the public hearing, but I don't understand. We have no land in Barrington that I know.
Well, I think that's just a mistake.
That's probably.
Yeah, we have no.
Okay.
Yeah, no, not that I'm aware of.
I'm like, do we have any vested interest?
No.
Sounds like they'll want to do something with it.
We don't even abut Barrington.
Yeah, they just sent it to the wrong. It's hilarious.
Yeah, okay.
And this is our copy of Over Maintenance Action Group.
Excuse
this
me.
Is all of our paperwork for all of our new
culverts, well,
correct?
Oh, this must be the wetlands permitting that they filed on our behalf for our culverts. I don't know if it's all three, can you tell? Is it all three locations?
Willie Street, Pine Street, and Lower Mill.
Yep.
And proposed culvert replacements, Willie Street, Pine Street, Lower Mill, March 2017. All right.
So that is available, if anyone would like to look at that.
And this is our copy. So the nice, lovely book.
We'll make, keep this. Well, somewhere so that, you know, if somebody wants to come by and look at it, they can look at it, I don't.
I guess.
Okay, that's fine.
Anything in current construction seems available.
Perfect, that's, as long as we all know that's where it is, it's perfect.
That's it, that's all I got.
Okay, so we're done now, we can check in with our folks. Okay, any comments, questions?
Go ahead, you can go first.
Just thank you for clarification on what you plan to do with funds brought in through the different committees. There was some confusion last night about how to handle that.
Yeah, we have no capacity to actually carry that forward, but, you know, we can provide the same benefit by bringing it into the budget.
At one point, non-lapsing funds had been on the agenda for the historic committee. Did that get resolved, or did it just fall off the agenda due to other busy things?
We probably just took it off because it had been on there so long. Maybe I shouldn't have. Maybe it was me. Maybe it was a group thing. I don't remember.
That's fine. I was just wondering.
If the committee, who is this question in the historical committee's hands to recommend or do the research? I mean, it seems to me that would be a good place to start, is to have the historical committee say, Here's how we think this could work. I mean, it would be nice if we could do that, but, you know, there are other things that we're, you know, working on and involved with. So if the historical committee wants to do some of the research and say, you know, maybe it could only happen if you're a historical commission. I don't know. Maybe there's this mechanism or that mechanism. You could also feel free to talk to Caroline and see if she belongs to listservs and can ask some questions.
We said we were going to wait until after town meeting, and then
we just, and it could be that
we probably made a decision for it.
Yeah, and so.
We do have some information, but it was not gotten in the way that I believe this board wanted. And one of the committee members.
One of the committee members reached out directly to the Municipal Association, remember? We also, why? And then we couldn't believe they actually responded. But it wasn't done with malice, right? I think it was.
So
she thought she could.
We can bring that information.
You have some information, yeah, bring it to us.
I think we do, yeah.
We can gather it and bring it back.
Here, I'll put it back on the agenda then. Okay, very good.
And I think it may be a simple resolution.
Okay, even better. You like simple. Hang on, let me log back on.
And I'm not sure if it's already been done or not, so worth looking into.
I believe I said at the meeting, I'll check with the Municipal Association, and the person who we should check with the Municipal Association just sent an email to their inquiries page, that link, and actually responded, which is a whole other question. Opened up a whole other conversation, anyways.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, whatever. It's okay. Anything else?
No.
Anything, Charlie?
The trustees of the trust fund.
Yeah.
You're withdrawing $225,000 from that. How much is in it?
Oh, I don't know. It's in the financial statement, right?
I believe it's $225,000, correct? For the CIP? Is that what you're pulling it from?
All the warrant articles.
It's all warrant articles. Some are from the CIP, one is from the reval. They're not going to give us money they don't have. I can pretty much guarantee that.
Yeah, well, I'm just trying to ingest all of this because any money that came out of a warrant can only be used for that warrant.
Yes, but money is a fungible asset. And so, you know, it will, the money that we take out of that will be used for projects. Can I guarantee that this $1 that came out of that is used, you know, I mean, no, it's a fungible asset. But yes, it will be accounted for.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Just
part of our cash flow plan.
Because that's usually done at the end of the year, correct?
Yeah, exactly. So but we can make use of that money now. So rather than, you know, creating some other kind of mechanism that will cost the town money, it seems to be a good approach to manage that. Anything else?
Who
cleans the bathroom with the hired department right now?
Probably Jeff.
There's not that many people use it, why can't that?
Transfer station.
Yeah. But I mean, it's all employees.
We haven't made any decision, we haven't even talked about it.
No, no, it's just an opinion, throwing it out.
Thank you.
So you're gonna have the town clerk clean this one?
No, because she's a maintenance here.
I know.
And I don't believe she has a right to speak to us.
She shouldn't be talking to me.
All right.
Okay.
Can we try to keep this simple?
No, I ain't got a problem.
Thank you. All right, anything else?
Nope.
Nope.
Okay. Are we ready to rock and roll and say goodbye, say goodnight?
Let's adjourn.
Okay, by consensus?
Oh, I'm so sorry, oh, thank God. Thank you, Michael, for keeping us on track, oh.
Thank you, Michael.
All right, motion to go into non-public, okay.
Second.
Second, okay, I'll do a roll call, Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne?
Yes.